video, we'll be taking a quick look at the laptops we are getting as part of EPISD Power-Up. On the right-hand side of the laptop, you'll see a series of ports and connectors. The first one is the HDMI port. You probably have seen HDMI ports on your television sets at home. HDMI is great, but not all of your projectors in classrooms have HDMI ports. If you want to connect the laptop to a projector that doesn't have an HDMI port, you may need an HDMI to VGA adapter. It looks like this, and you probably can figure out how to use it pretty fast. The two other ports on the right-hand side are USB ports. We actually have one USB 3 port and one that is a USB 2 port. Don't worry, they're both USB ports and will work with any of your USB devices, like your flash drives or anything else that has a USB connection. The next port is a headset jack. You can use your smartphone earbuds with a mic here if you want, or just use it for headphones. Either one works. Check out the webcam at the top of the screen and the two microphone holes on either side. That's for doing things like Skyping or doing a webcast. Look at the keyboard. This is the power button. You know what that is for. The laptop's trackpad doesn't look like it has a left or right click. Don't worry, it does. Right click is in the lower right corner and left click is on the left side. You will get the hang of it in about a minute. It's that easy, I promise. You can scroll up and scroll down using two fingers sliding on the trackpad. This is the power connector. Charge your laptop here. Hey, these guys can hold an 8-hour charge, so bring it to school charged and ready to go each day. You might not be able to have a chance to recharge during the day, so the best bet is to charge overnight, every night. This is the SD card slot. You can expand your computer storage using an SD card. SD cards come in a bunch of different sizes. Want more space? Use an SD card, or use your Office 365 OneDrive. If you need to install extra software or store a bunch of files on your computer, then you will need to get an SD card to expand your storage. Remember, guys, we have to make these computers last, so we need to take care of them. Make sure you dust off your keyboard and wipe off your screen on a regular basis. Use a soft cloth that has been lightly sprayed with a mild cleaning solution, like the ones you can pick up at places like Walmart or office supply stores. Don't forget, when you shut down the laptop, be sure that you don't have a pencil or anything that might crack the screen or cause problems with the latches and hinges. Thanks for watching, and thanks for powering up with EPISD's Power Up.